MrExcel Podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from MrExcel Podcast, episode 1668, Subtotal in Footer. Hey, welcome back to the MrExcel Netcast. I'm Bill Jell, and today's question sent in. So it's St. Patrick's Day weekend, right? And MRAM sends this question, and he says, hey, I want to put a subtotal of the totals so far in the footer of each page. And I initially wrote back and said, no way, it'll never happen, forget it. But then he kept asking questions. And so here we are Monday morning, and I think I have two different ways to get a subtotal in the footer. And what MRAM said is, well, it's really frustrating for the insert new rows or delete new rows, the subtotal needs to move. All right, so I have two ways to do this. I'm going to do one way today that's a formula way, and tomorrow we'll try a VBA macro way. First thing we do, you want to make sure that you get your page layout set up so that you'll never change it. Choose the margins that you want. Make sure to set up the print title. So here I have rows 1 to 5 repeating at the top of each page. Get everything exactly like you want it, and then take a look at print preview. So I just did Control P, Excel 2010 and newer, you can just do Control P and you get print preview over here. And it looks like the invoices run from 1 to 40, and I know that none have been deleted here. So there's 40 rows on the first page, and then from 41 to 80 on the second page. Reliably, I'm getting 40 rows on every page. Now, if we change the row height later, this whole thing's going to fall apart. But right now, I can count on 40 rows in each page. So, let's build this formula one step at a time. Equal row will tell me the row number of the current row, right? So, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And think about division. When you were learning division way back in third or fourth or second grade, whenever you learned division, initially, when you would do division, you would often express the answer as a number with a remainder. All right, so if I asked for 45 divided by 40, the answer would be 1 remainder 5. 1 remainder 5. And what I need to do here is I need to find the rows where the remainder of this number divided by 40 is equal to 5. Okay, because that will be the last row on each page. So there is a great function in Excel that will let us find the remainder, and that function is called mod. So I want the mod of this row number divided by 40, and that's going to give me the remainder of to the division. So let's go back down to our row 45 so you can see. So here's row 45, 45 divided by 40, the remainder is 5. Mod doesn't bother to tell you what the first number was. It only tells you what the remainder was. By the way, if you need that first number, I think you use quotient. So quotient and mod will give you the answer and the remainder. All right, so now I can tell whether I'm on the last row of the page when this is equal to 5. All right, so from there, we say equal if this whole thing is equal to 5, then I want to put a total. And the total is going to be the sum from, I always want to go from E6, so $6, down to the current row, which in this case is still E6. It's always confusing in the first cell there. Otherwise, show nothing at all. All right, and I'll press Control Enter there. And they give me the warning that, hey, I'm ignoring adjacent cells, but that's okay in this particular case. So at the end of page 1, we have 96,000. If I scroll down to the bottom of page 2, 19,1100, and it should continue to grow. Now, maybe people won't know what that is, so we should put a heading that says total all pages so far, or something like that. Okay, now what if we just wanted a total of the current page? So not total of all pages so far, but total of this page. So this function, the sum function, is going to have to grab a variable range that grabs the last 40 rows. And for that, I'm going to use the offset function. So we're going to start from the current cell, that's F6. I'm going to go minus 39 rows up, minus one column over, and grab a range that's 40 rows tall by one column wide. Close the offset, and double click to shoot that down, page down, 96,000. Now here's the big test. So if we insert 3 new rows, and we'll just add 1,000 to each of those. Our total there moved. It's still appearing on row 45 thanks to our mod function, and it's grabbing the last 40 cells. So even if we insert rows, delete rows, the total is going to appear to move to the correct place, and we will get a total at the bottom of each page. All right, so that's my formula-based solution for MRAM. Tomorrow we'll try a VBA solution. Well, I want to thank everyone for stopping by. I want to thank MRAM for sending that question in. See you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.